I know he's in there. Huh? If he doesn't come out, I'll go in and get him.
I'm sorry, I've already told you the prince is not here. You can leave a message for him if you wish.
A message? Oh, she's beautiful.
And that, my friends, was Snow White. Yes, she's much different than her incarnation in the Disney movie, that's for sure. Now here, we have new enemies, the exclusive armor skeleton and the archery zombies. They're kind of a main, not so much at first, but when you get more greater numbers, they're definitely a main. Oh yeah, and those other enemies are now replaced by What the Throw Cake. Yeah, so replaced by Jokes, and now Throw Cake, and when these balls come down exactly more points, I would like. Killian and I just better be benefit because they're exactly like the red skeletons going in a straight line to their dial. Archers before one, E. Check out that is what we're looking for, angle. Yeah, that's it. So killing these guys first is more so viable to your plan of action. Killing that will give you something. It often varies. At times I've just gotten zombies from it, and it's not very pleasant. Like everything else, you can destroy this entire room, you can destroy even the castle in the background there. And no, I'm not lying. Don't see why I would. As this game's just pure epic like that, it allows you to do such things. You destroy everything from plant to the castle itself. Why would you not want to destroy it? Gives you more points, gives you more cleanup. Allows you to finish the level a lot faster. That. Points. Not a lot of points, but hey, every 100 points counts. So the statues is also very good. Because you can also get more points as you clean up and get you items that you would very desperately want if you were in the zombie apocalypse. Give me a choice, and if you choice, got that one good. See, the castle's almost already gone. Nice. Now the fat zombies here, they don't run at you. More so throw projectiles at you, which is a pain. It's not much better, but hey, better than having balls charge for you. Or rush you, because you know the phrase, Zerg Rush! That's what they normally do when they ever lay top of that at the ground. They Zerg Rush you. So here they throw the projectiles. I enjoy. Also, shooting up the castle makes the whole thing fall apart, which is awesome. And I'll shoot at the little tower spout. No! And there was an extra life right there. That's when this game is cruel to you, and they throw a life at you right after you die. And again, cutscene doesn't change at all, it's the same exact thing, it's just, you know, replayed. So, I died after having 4 levels of no death. Oh well. Will be a time when I do post a perfect run of this, where I don't die at all, but just not now. I won't have commentary, of course, but, well, duh. Perfect run means I have to shut up and concentrate. There it goes. And that's it. Wrong weapon. Just wasted. Yep, arrow. Always question me. Now I know my answer. I guess death proves something to me. I can now destroy those things. Which is nice. Yeah, this level is not necessarily my favorite because it's so damn packed with enemies. And the fact that it's so much more prone to you dying than anything else in the entire game. This one is probably considered the most hard to make. It's not necessarily that hard in the long run. Compared to all the other levels, you stick them all together, This one probably weighs pretty fairly. We've played other levels on all of us. It's somewhat of a fitting thing before the end of the game. Which, oh my gosh, spoilers, yeah, the final boss is right beyond that castle door. Game's short, it's on the freaking wait when you want. It's limited like what? How many megabytes? Not that long. Which I'm personally upset about, and I just got hit. Oh. It's only the first time, so it's not that big of a deal. Setting the suits of armor on fire isn't going to do you much. It just adds to your point total and just knocks the legs off. Killing them normally makes it better, but just shoot them in the chest would be great. Too much shooting any of these enemies in the chest prominently warns instant death. So then they can't still attack without their head, which is what they did. Back down. Jeez. Damn, they're not gonna do their little rush technique like they always do on the other levels. This is good. Open the doors of the castle by mistake and shoot down part of the castle by accident. Didn't mean to do that, Snow White. I mean, I know you lived here and all that, but kill everything for points. Points more important than Snow White's castle. Yes. Ooh, ammo. Ammo for flamethrower. Yes. Totally worth it. Alright, now I'm gonna shoot that down. Shoot this down because I know it has that light thing. Yes! So close last time! Could have had that. But no! The game had killed me. It was right here too, my god. It was depressing. Die. There we go. Hey. I'm kind of glad they don't come charging at you with their amazing jaws of death. There we go. One that's smoking dead, and now we're just gonna kill the rest of the zombies and then work on destroying the rest of the castle. There we go. Next. Now I'm gonna try to use this though. That works. Die by burns. I don't care who you are. To be the world's greatest magician, if you are set on fire, you are to die, not douse yourself in water. Even if it is magic, like, everything must die by fire. Kill that. Kill it. Yep. Yep. Ah! God. Can't shoot that. Okay. I think that you have all things you have to destroy the entire level. Depressing. That's just all these birds now. Whoa! You almost got me, good sir. You're dead. Shoot you in the head. Shoot you in the head. Shoot you and kill the rest. Oh gosh, he's back. On fire. There we go. That's better. You die now, the rest of you go back on fire and die. Please make help. Yes! Aha! And 3 hits remaining.